Everybody say, go get those blessings. When you rock with the Spirit of God, your hands change like this. Strength in the prayer when you all work together. It's gotta be love. And still, I give him the highest praise. Then do it then. Come on, hallelujah. Amen. What's up, y'all? Sunday. Hey. So good. So glad to see y'all. Woo. What's up, y'all? Hey. Welcome, welcome. Time for church, y'all. Let's go. Hey. Your mama, tell everybody, tell your homies, time to tune in, get that church. Let's go. Let's go. Amen. Woo. Yeah. Okay. I'm glad y'all coming to church. We are free through Christ Jesus. You know what I mean? So let me play y'all this real quick. Don't be afraid to be yourself. Can y'all hear me okay? Hey. What's up, Gap? What's up, Miss Tash? Kizzy Lou Woo? Steffi Boo? Malik? Hey. Haney? I'm shouting out everybody. Calvin? Rayma, I see you. Jesus, Jesus. 987 Brooklyn. Ooh, I'm not afraid to be me. Hey. I'm not afraid to be me. Smooth it down. Welcome, 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 welcome. Yes, yes, yes. It's so good to see everybody. That was Elevate. I was playing that earlier by Byron Juwan. And then I just played What Up, RPRG. Yeah, free. What's up, man? So, I'm excited, y'all. Let's get this thing started. Super excited. Today's message is called He Who Has Ears, Let Them Hear. All right? So, let them hear. Hear, you want to hear the Lord. So let's do a quick prayer real quick, y'all. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for everybody that's watching right now, everybody that has tuned in to this live on My Spirit Food. I pray that it is a blessing to them. Lord, let me speak the words that you want me to speak. This is your message, Heavenly Father. So I just thank you for giving me this message, Lord. And I just thank you for everybody that's watching, that they are blessed. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. 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 So, yo, my great-grandfather, right, he had this saying. His saying was, if you don't know something, ask somebody. If you don't know something, ask somebody, okay? So it's simple, but it's so true. I mean, it's so simple, but it's very true. And I would like to add something to that statement, all right? I want to add a little something to it, which is, if you don't know something, ask somebody that has wisdom on the subject. They have wisdom on the subject that you're asking about, okay? You want to make sure that they have that wisdom. You know, I use the word wisdom because wisdom means the quality of having experience, knowledge, and good judgment, okay? The quality of being wise, the soundness of an action or decision with regard to the application of experience. Knowledge. We're talking about knowledge. We're talking about good judgment. Okay, good judgment, soundness. Now, the word soundness, we hear that a lot within scripture. We hear it a lot of times, soundness. The word soundness means the state of being in a good condition, okay? Robustness, mental and physical, soundness. The quality of being based on valid reason or good judgment. There it is again, good judgment. We will win because of the soundness of our arguments, the quality of being competent or reliable. You know, you hear people say this all the time in Bible verses where they say, I have a sound mind. I have a sound mind, okay? So if you turn to 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7, do that for me. Turn to 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7, all right? Hey, mama, see you in there. What's happening? Yeah. So turn to 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. And it says, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but a power and of love and a sound mind. A sound mind. Okay, so now you know what that means when you hear sound mind. You hear good judgment. Okay, the quality of being based on valid reason, good judgment. That's a sound mind, okay? What can happen when you do not know the answer to something? Okay, so like when you don't know the answer to something, and what can happen if you don't know it? You get anxiety, you know what I mean? You start to, things start to come up in your mind, you know what I mean? Because you're unsure about the question, because you just don't have the answer. And you're like, man, I don't have the answer to what I want to do in my life. And you're so unsure about the situation, so anxiety can come up and stress can come up, which can all be detrimental to us, okay? So let's go back to 2 Timothy. You should already be there. Chapter 1, verse 7. And see why Timothy was developing a spirit of fear, okay? So I want you to turn there. So it says, for God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. All right. Power and of love and a sound mind. Now, Timothy was developing a spirit of fear. Okay. Because of the fact that around this time, a non-believer, I see dad, what's happening? A non-believer, Nero was persecuting and killing believers and in a very cruel way. Okay. And Timothy, who was a pastor of the church of Ephesus, found out that Nero's secret police was coming to kill him, okay? Right? As he was thinking about his threat, as he contemplated what to do, and he did not have the answer, a spirit of fear started to come over him, okay? But he didn't make a drastic move in fear, all right? He did not make a drastic move. Fearful emotions can do that. You know, if when you wait on something and you're waiting for an answer from God, you can be fearful, but you have to trust in the Lord. All right. So he did not make a drastic decision. He trusted in the Lord. All right. And he waited for God to give him a righteous answer, a righteous answer. And then a letter was sent to Timothy from Paul, who knew exactly what Timothy was going through because he had experienced it before, and he knew how to encourage Timothy because he had knowledge on the issue at hand, and he can make good judgment because he's been through it before. So he later goes on to tell Timothy what to do. God used Paul, a righteous man who loves God, to help another righteous man, Timothy, who loves God, through something. It was answered prayer, okay? Answered prayer. You want answered prayer to something, or you don't know the answer, you need to say this to the Lord. You need to say, help me in this situation. Okay, send me the right person to help me get through this. Go to the Lord for the right answer, and he will send people your way. God has an army of intelligent, righteous men and women that will help you here on earth because it's part of their assignment, it's part of their purpose here on earth to help you. And when they do, they will be blessed. That's how you hear it's a blessing to be a blessing. You know what I mean? So that's why they're here to help you, and it's part of their purpose and it's part of God's plan. But what you have to understand is that the devil also has people on earth. These people do not yet know the authority that they have through Jesus Christ. Okay, so they don't know the authority that they have through Jesus Christ, or they have not accepted Jesus in their life yet, or accepted Jesus. So the devil is using them by confusing them, adding setbacks, and causing confusion in their life. And when you seek an answer from that type of person, whoo, the advice that you're going to get is going to be bad. You're going to get bad advice, okay? You're going to get the wrong answers because these people are not letting the Lord lead them, okay? Because we can control our choices, but we can't control the consequences from those choices, all right? So we have to be careful who we choose to follow, do we follow this advice? You know what I mean? You have to make sure that it's a righteous person that you're going to for that righteous advice. That's why you have to go to God first to make sure that that person is righteous. Okay, so you have to choose wisely with a sound mind, because a bad answer to a good question can ruin your life. All right, you can write that down. A bad answer to a good question can ruin your life if you follow the advice of the bad answer. All right. It might feel right at the moment. Trust me, it might feel right at the moment. But you know what they saying could give you a bad outcome. All right. And that you need to talk to someone else. Maybe you should talk to someone else. You know, somebody tells you something. He's like, man, you need to do this, man, because, yo, it worked out for me like this. Right. And you start to think like, man, I don't know if this would be right for me to do this. Right. When you start feeling that, it's time for you to go get a second opinion. Okay, you know, you ever been to the doctor and they tell you something and they say, well, you should go get a second opinion. So in anything in life, you should always go get a second opinion. And your first opinion, go to Jesus. And even when someone comes to you and says something, go to Jesus again. Okay, go and talk to him. You got to do that just to make sure you're making the right moves. All right. That like the saying, don't put all your eggs in one basket. You know what I mean? All right. So also the reason it is important that we go to God in prayer, because people have snap judgment, okay? Snap judgment based on how someone looks or how that person may be perceived. You know what I mean? You might think, oh, that person can't give me good advice. You know what I mean? And so, or someone might look like they got it all together. You know what I mean? They got it all together. And you have that snap judgment like, yeah, they got it all together. I know what's going to be cool. But you have to look at how they're living. You know, take time to talk to them. See how they're speaking. See how the integrity that they have. How do they treat their family? How do they treat their money? How do they treat anything in life? You have to look at that and then go to God and listen so he can help you listen correctly. Your first question should be to God. And when people come to you, or when you think this might be from God, that person, that advice, in your prayer time, do a review, okay? Do a recap of your time with that person and talk to God about it. Okay. What was their history on the subject? Is it a truthful person? You know, are they in their right mind? That's big. And when God confirms it in your spirit, confirms it in your spirit. Now, sometimes people get the right answer, but they let fear come back in and steer them away. So sometimes, you know, you do this, right? You do this spiritual checklist of that conversation with that person. And you go, yes, this is good advice. And it came from God. Okay. But then what some believers do is that they allow this fear to come in and then take them away from that good path that they were on. They were leveling up, but then all of a sudden fear came in. You know, that is why we must always keep a sound mind. So you can hear God clearly, meaning if you spend time with God, spend time in the Word, meditating, praying, you know, when you hear someone speaking a message or to you that is a blessing and give you a blessing with through their answer, you know what I mean? You have to have discernment, and only God can give you that discernment. All right. And you will feel the love in it. You'll feel the love in it because it's familiar. Okay. See, people always go like, well, how do I know it's God? Well, if you spend time with God, then it's familiar. Like my beautiful wife, she's in here right now. My beautiful wife, I see her in there. What's up, Asia? And it's like, if somebody come up to me and they say, Asia said this, Asia said that. And if I know it's not right, and I spend time with Asia all the time, and I know my beautiful wife, we have a relationship, we hang out all the time, I would know immediately that this person is not telling the truth. I'll be like, wait, I know Asia. I know she didn't say that. Okay. So it's the same thing. It's something that familiar. If you spend time with the Lord, you know, when somebody is really speaking about what the Lord is telling you, okay, you'll know immediately because you're spending time with them all the time. Okay. So God will let you know. Keep checking in with them. Check in with them. Be like, hey, is this you? This feeling, this answer that I got, is this you, Lord? Is this you? You know, check in, you know, take time to pray. Take time, you know, to listen to the word. Somebody might tell you something within the sermon. You know what I mean? And you go, man, that was the answer that I needed. But why did you get that? Because you went to a place of worship. You got on social media and you listened to someone speaking in a righteous way, you know, getting a message from the Lord. Do those things. All right. Do not doubt. Do not turn away. Stay around things that are holy, holy, because you need to train yourself. You need to train your ear to hear and to understand what the Lord is telling you. Okay. Like as believers, we are given spiritual hearing aids. Okay. Spiritual hearing aids. We can hear what others choose not to hear. All right. So we're given these spiritual hearing aids. We get direction from the Lord. We are at peace because we took time to listen to righteousness and righteousness direction. Faith. That's what that's about. Faith come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. All right. I know all y'all believers know that in there. Okay. So Jesus told a parable about exactly what I'm talking about. Okay. So Jesus told a parable about hearing from the Lord and following his good answers to your life's questions. Okay. Because that's what we're talking about. When you really need some good answers to a difficult time. All right. So God is telling you how to hear in this time and how to stay obedient and righteous during this time. So I want you to turn to the parable of the sower. Okay. I want you to turn there because this is where he really explains it in this parable really good. Turn to Matthew chapter 13. Shout out to everybody that just came in. I see you. What up? Yes. Turn to Matthew chapter 13. Okay. So it says, that same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat by the lake. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat in it, while all the people stood on the shore. Then he told them many things in parables, saying, a farmer went out to sow his seed. Okay. As he was scattering the seed, some fell along the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some fell along rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly because the soil was shallow. But then the sun came up. The plants were scorched and they withered because they had no root. Other seed fell among thorns, which grew up and choked the plants. Still, other seed fell on good soil where it produced a good crop, 160 or 30 times what was sown. Whoever has ears, let them hear. Let them hear. Okay, let them hear. The disciples came to him and asked, why do you speak to the people in parables? All right. He replied, because the knowledge of the secrets of the kingdom of heaven has been given to you, but not to them. Whoever has will be given more, and they will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even what they have will be taken from them. This is why I speak to them in parables. Though seeing, they do not see. Though hearing, they do not hear or understand. In them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah. You will be ever hearing, but never understanding. You will be ever seeing, but never perceiving. For this people's heart has become close. They hardly hear with their ears, and they have closed their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hearts, and turn, and I would heal them. Okay? That's what I was talking about earlier, where people are being letting the devil lead them, and they don't know the authority they have through Jesus Christ. So they can see, they can hear, but they're not hearing and seeing correctly, all right? Spiritually. Okay, on what they really can do in their life for the kingdom and the blessings that they can have. So they walk around confused and not seeing the real them and the real life that they can have. You know what I mean? So, but blessed, we'll continue, but blessed are your eyes because they see and your ears because they hear. For truly, I tell you, many prophets and righteous people long to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear. Okay, so right there is deep because he said prophets and righteous people. So there are believers that allow fear to jump inside of their life and will allow people to come into their life and give them bad advice. So that's why the Lord is saying that you need to keep your eyes and your ears and your focus on him, because people can come up and, you know, they can have a certain type of swag, but they give you the wrong advice. That's why you have to have discernment, okay? Discernment. You just never know. So because you never know, we can't lean on our own understanding. So we have to go to the Lord so that he can give us discernment on what is good advice and who to follow, because it can come in all kind of different ways, all right? Because the Lord is using his people, okay? So, for truly I tell you, many prophets and righteous people long to see what you see but did not see, and to hear what you hear but did not hear it. Now, some people get the message. They get a right answer, but they lose faith or give into temptation or fear. As believers, we have to keep our focus and our attention on God, all right? So you won't get trapped in continuous sin. Continuous sin. Continuous sin sucks, all right? It's just, it's like you're like on a hamster wheel. You know what I'm saying? It's like, man, I just want to get off this thing, man. I just want to get off. But when you focus, then it'll help you understand that, hey, if I just slow down this hamster wheel and pray for a minute, it'll stop, and then I could actually move my right leg or my left leg and get off this thing. You know what I mean? And get off this thing, you know? That's what it's all about, okay? Before I made God the head of everything in my life, I did that. I was saved, but I had fear and temptation. I had bad advice from some wrong people. I hung around because confusion, it caused confusion in my life. But thank God that God waited. He waited on me to get it. And that's the beautiful thing about it. God will wait on you to get it. All right. He'll wait on you to get it because he loves you. All right. He loves you. He knew someday that I would clean myself up. You know what I mean? He knew I would clean my ears with spiritual Q-tips. You know what I mean? Clean all that mess out of there. Get that waxy, sinful buildup that was in my ears so I can hear clearly. You know what I mean? And you know, I'm using the Q-tip as a metaphor. You know what I mean? But what I'm saying is that get that dirty past and the things that were in the past out of your head. Get it out of your head space. Get it out of your ears. Clean it out. Okay? Because it's over. You are following the Lord. Listen to him and how he knows that you're going to have a blessed future, and the love that he wants to have in your life will happen if you just clean it out and listen. You know what I mean? Just listen. All right. So I want you to keep reading. keep reading. We're on verse 18 right now. Verse 18. This is where God explains the parable. Okay. He's explaining the parable and he's explaining it to us because we're believers. Remember, we have our spiritual hearing aid so we can understand it. All right. So listen. Listen then to what the parable of the sower means. This is Jesus. He's breaking it down. Listen then to what the parable of the sower means. When anyone hears the message about the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what was sown in their heart. This is the seed sown along the path. Now, this is what I was talking about earlier. See, they hear it, but need more insight to get it. They know they need to get around kingdom people to understand more, but they allow the enemy to come into their life and say things like, you don't have time for that. You really don't believe that Christian stuff. You don't believe that. Ain't no future in that. And instead, they walk away, meaning they walk away from their purpose. Okay. They walk away from God. All right. So let's continue. And then it says the seed falling on rocky ground refers to someone who hears the word, okay, who hears the word and at once receives it with joy. But since they have no root, they last only a short time. When trouble or persecution comes because of the word, they quickly fall away. All right. So what that is saying, you see this all the time. Someone goes to church, right? You know, they receive joy from the word, but they do not study. All right. They do not pray. They do not stay connected within faith. This is what I was talking about earlier. Every day they are not rooted in the word. And when the enemy attacks, because he knows the blessed moves that can be made in that person's life, if they would just pay attention, if they would just listen. All right. And the things that could happen in their life, oh, that the Lord would do in their life. But because they're not doing that, he decides to cause trouble in their life. And because they are not rooted, they seek other answers than the good answer that was given to them in the beginning when they started to have joy and peace that they were feeling. They forget about that. They forget about that. But that's why you have to stay connected to the Lord. All right. Ooh. Keep your joy by staying close to the one that gives joy. I want you to write that down. All right. Keep your joy by staying close to the one that gives you joy. That's the Lord. That's the Lord. All right. Keep reading. 22. The seed falling amongst the thorns refers to someone who hears the word, but the worries of this life and the deceitfulness of wealth choke the word, making it unfruitful. Now that's deep when you think about that. That gets really, 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 really deep. Okay, so worrying causes so much trouble. It really does. And we talked about that. Worrying. People can worry themselves into sickness, okay? Worriness makes them believe the worst and brings fear. And fear and faith do not work together, okay? Write that down. Fear and faith do not work together, okay? So you can know something is hard, that is difficult, okay? You can know. It's not that you're not recognizing that whatever you're going through is hard or difficult. It's a difficult situation. But you know through faith that you can get through it. Faith says, even though I see that, also I see victory. Okay, as long as I keep pushing and trusting in the power of the Lord Jesus Christ, who created me to be great. You're great. You know, like, I don't know if y'all remember Tony the Tiger, but he had that cereal and he used to go, great. You're great. All right. Be like a tiger. You know what I mean? Be strong. All right. Now, I want you to keep reading. All right. 23. But the seed falling on good soil, refers to someone who hears the word and understands it, okay? This is the one who produces a crop, yielding 160 or 30 times what was sown, all right? So when you are on good soil, meaning that you're going to the Lord, you're hearing the Lord, okay? When you're hearing what the Lord saying about you, okay, when you're hearing how the Lord feels about you, when you're studying, It's blessings on blessings on blessings on blessings on blessings. That's why you always hear me do the hashtag go get them blessings or go get them blessings. I do that all the time because of the fact that when you're saying go get them blessings, you're saying I know what I am supposed to be receiving. It's like you're saying because I'm a child of God, I wake up expecting to receive blessings. I'm expecting to receive blessings because I'm being obedient. I'm following the Lord. I know what I'm doing through Christ Jesus, and I know he's directing my path. So that reason, for that reason alone, I know I'm going to be blessed 100-fold, millions, billions. I'm going to just be blessed in so many ways, okay? In every part of my life, my lifestyle, my marriage, everything, finances, blessed in everything in your life because I'm putting the Lord right in the middle of everything that's in my life. Okay? That's what you have to do. That's what you have to do. And you know when it's pulling at you. You know when grandma calling you talking about, hey, just go to church. Hey, just watch the this IG live of this preacher I saw. You know what I mean? And you know you going through some stuff. You know what I mean? And somebody might be trying to pull you away from that, man, just because you talked about it and you felt embarrassed. You're like, man, I listened to the Lord, or I was on social media and I listened to this pastor, and the person that you around be like, man, whatever, man, anybody got the time for that? Yeah, but you got time for it. You got time for it. You know why? Because you got eternal life that's going to happen. So you want to make sure that you are on the way to doing that. You know what I'm saying? You have time to go listen because you need to save your life. You need to save your family's life. You need to save generations and generations after that so they can see the progress and the blessings that the Lord has and can do through you in your life. People are watching you. That person that might say something negative, they're going through a negative time too, and they just want to see somebody that they know get blessed, because that's the thing. They're not seeing it. They're not seeing anybody around them that is being blessed, but at the same time, they're not seeking it. They're not seeking it. When you seek it, you'll find it. You'll be like, whoa, I didn't even know the people down the corner, the reason why they have the things that they have, or the reason why blessings is happening in their life is because they love the Lord. Take the time to go to the Lord, and the Lord will open up these amazing doors in your life and things that you didn't even see at first. You start to see things that you weren't listening to before. You start to listen. He'll change your life. That's why they say you become new, renewed each day. You become new. You become a new person. You're seeing through new eyes. You're hearing through new ears. Okay? You're speaking differently. You know? Renewed, renewed. All right? So turn to Proverbs. I want you to turn to Proverbs chapter 2, 2 through 5. Okay? Verse 2 through 5. Proverbs chapter 2, 2 through 5. Yeah. All right. Now, this is more where it's talking about your ears and your hearing and spending time with Christ. Okay? So I love these verses. I'm going to give you a few of them that I want you to write down. All right. So Proverbs chapter 2, verse 2 through 5. Making your ear attentive to wisdom and inclining your heart to understanding. Yes, if you call out for insight and raise your voice for understanding, if you seek it like silver and search for it as for hidden treasures, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. Find the knowledge of God. Now, that fear of the Lord that they're talking about is the respect. Respect. It's not like you're going, oh, I fear the Lord, but it's the respect. The respect, the obedience, the honor. You know what I mean? That's what they're talking about. And the reason I named my youngest daughter Wisdom, the reason me and Asia named our daughter Wisdom, because we wanted to be reminded of having wisdom. You know what I mean? And we prayed for wisdom to be born. And so we knew to go to the Lord to pray for a blessing in our lives. And when our beautiful daughter was born, to pay homage and to say, thank you, Jesus, we named her Wisdom. We named her Wisdom. Okay. So we always remember, okay, that we need to go to the Lord within prayer. We need to have good judgment and have blessings in our lives, and blessings on blessings on blessings. Okay. So turn to Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean on your own understanding. Now, I mentioned that earlier, and that's where you find it. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and not on your own understanding, okay? There's only one God, all right? We can't be God Jr., you know, Jesus Jr., you know what I mean? It's only one, okay? So when we try to figure it out on our own, we are definitely going to bump our heads because the Lord knows the path. He knows the path and where we need to go. And that's not to say that you're going to make mistakes at times. That's okay. If no one's perfect because we're not the Lord. You know what I mean? So that's why we have to go to him. And when we go to him, then that's when people start to look at you like, yo, what they got? You know, some type of cheat code in life. What is going on? What's this, you know, perfect thing that they're doing? But what they don't know is I hit the flow and you know what I mean? That's that song, you know, from Mary Mary, is that they don't know that you go home and you hit the floor and you get on your knees and you pray every day, okay? And because you know that you want to have a great outcome and that you're an overcomer because you give it to the Lord. You give it to the Lord. Woo! Give it to the Lord every time. I'm telling you it's going to work. I'm going to tell you it's going to work. If you're in here and you never had answered prayer, listen to me. Listen to me. If you're going through something, take time to pray. Take time to go to the Lord and you will receive so many blessings. Because I've been in some dark places. I've been through some dark times, man. But when I decided I'm going to turn around and I'm going to get on my knees and I'm going to pray and I'm going to let the Lord lead me and not me trying to lead everything because I'm mad and I got to get back at this person and I got to get revenge and I'm mad at the world. I'm mad at life and I got to figure it out on my own because I can do it. You know what I'm saying? People need to respect me. No, it was more of respect the Lord. Know that he can get you through it. Sacrifice. Just be like, look, man, it ain't about me. It ain't about me. It's about the Lord and who I can help through the Lord. Okay? And then that's when blessings started just open up. I started seeing things like, whoa, that's what that meant? Oh, this is how I get down? Oh, I started hearing things differently. Wanting to help people. You know what I mean? Forgive the ones that were wrong to me and now I'm cool with those people. You know what I mean? Or forgive people and then just let them go be who they gonna go be or let people out of my life that did not need to be in my life. The Lord just let me start seeing all kind of things and opened up so many beautiful things in my life, you know, because the enemy can't hide. The enemy can't hide because what is going on that's wrong, God will shine a light on it so big, you know what I mean? And you'll go, oh, you know what I mean? But if you don't have that light on you all the time and with you, you can't see it. But when you go to the Lord, that's why we're the light of the world. You know what I'm saying? God will show you. He'll show you. He'll show you. You know what I mean? Use that spiritual flashlight. Yeah. So turn to Proverbs chapter 3, 13 through 18. Proverbs chapter 3, 13 through 18. Yeah. All right. So Proverbs 3. Verse 13 through 18. Okay, so it says, blessed is the one who finds wisdom, all right? And the one who gets understanding, for the gain from her is better than gain from silver, and her profit better than gold. She is more precious than jewels, and nothing you desire can compare with her. Long life is in her right hand, and her left hand are riches and honor. Her ways are ways of pleasantness, and all her paths are peace. I love this verse, okay? I love this verse. The wisdom that it's talking about. Wisdom, good judgment, understanding, going through something, learning while you're going through it. So then that way you can help others. And it's deep how they use wisdom with saying her. But they're saying her because women, all the ladies that are in here, are amazing. You know what I mean? And God made you all to help us get through life as well. Help us, you know, as helpers. Proverbs 31, women are blessed. We talked about that on Mother's Day. And it's your help. That's another help. Having that wisdom in your life is another help in your life. It's a help in your life. You know what I mean? So, and it's precious, okay? It's precious, pleasant, okay? It feels good. You know what I mean? It's sweet. You know what I mean? It's sweet. So you have to look at that. You don't want your life to be darkness and it's hard and you can't stand it and I'm confused and I hate it. Look, I've been through that. That sucks. You know what I mean? That sucks when you can't, you just, your mind, you're trapped. Feel like you're in a fishbowl and you're just like, man, that's just, you just wake up like, ugh. But now I wake up like, yes, 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 yes. You know, who can I talk to today? Who can I bless today? Who can, you know, bless me with a good word? You know, you wake up expecting blessings. That's what I'm talking about. Wake up expecting blessings because you're part of the royal family. You're part of the kingdom of heaven. Okay. All right. So maybe you hearing this, right? You're hearing this right now and you're saying, I need more understanding of this. I need more understanding. I want to be rooted and grounded with God. I want peace. I want wisdom and to walk in love. And I need that in my life. Then you need to give your life to Christ. All right. That's what you need to do. Give your life to Christ. You need to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. And if that's you, I want you to repeat these words after me. Okay. Repeat these words. And when you say it, I want you to believe it in your heart. Because obviously you're going through something right now and you want to change. Okay. So if you want that change, you got to believe it in your heart when you say it. And you got to believe that God is accepting you and you're accepting him. You're accepting Jesus in your life to change it around. All right. So repeat these words after me. I am a sinner, but I do not want to sin anymore. I believe that Jesus died on the cross and rose again. I believe that Jesus was God in the flesh. Jesus, as my Lord and High Priest, I invite you into my heart. You are Lord and Savior over everything I do. Today, I am saved. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. I always get emotional when I say that and I have you say it because I know it's a change in people's lives. I know it's a change. This is the change we need. This is the change we need. Look, you got to remember every emotional wall that we create in our lives, there's always a blessed doorway out of that emotional wall. And that is the Lord Jesus Christ. He's there waiting for you. You just have to be obedient to him and you will see the door, the blessed doorway out of these emotional walls that we create. Okay. All right. So if you want the Holy Spirit in your life and you want to have effective prayer, that we're what we're talking about. All you have to do is just invite the Holy Spirit in as well. You know what I mean? That's the same thing. That's all you have to do. The Lord says, if you ask, you know what I mean? If you ask, he will infill you with the Holy Spirit and you'll be able to speak in other tongues with the Holy Spirit tongue. All right. So if you want to do that, I want to take you through that. Okay. So you say, Lord, you said that if I ask that you would fill me with the evidence and power to live the way you want me to live, to understand your word according to the leading and the direction and guidance of the Holy Spirit. Lord, I want to pray effectively and powerfully. And you said, if I ask, you would infill me with the Holy Spirit. So I'm asking. Now, I want you to say, fill me with the Holy Spirit. Now, when I say, be filled with the Holy Spirit, say, I am filled with the Holy Spirit. Be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, everyone that already is filled up with the Holy Spirit and can speak in other tongues, I want you to do it softly. Softly pray for them. Pray for those that are receiving the Holy Spirit right now. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. This is important. We have to do these things. It's important. It's important. This is our spiritual armor. How we get through things. How we get through things. All right. Now, I'm sure that if you want any prayer, if you need prayer, okay, if you need prayer in your life and you need prayer to happen in your life, you definitely can hit us up. All right. I want you to DM us. I want you to hit us up. DM us. Let us know that you need prayer in your life. And we will definitely send you over everything that you need. Everything that you need. If you did that prayer, I want you to be able to. Sorry, I dropped something. If you did that prayer, I want you to hit me up and let me know so we can send you more information. More information. Now, if you want to tithe, okay, if you want to tithe and you want to continue to tithe, you want to continue to give an offering, I want you to be able to do that. So I want you to text MYSFCC, okay, MYSFCC to 7977, all right, to 7977, all right. Now, when you do that, MYSFCC, text that to 7977. Okay. Now, when you do that, you will receive a message from PushPay app, and you'll be able to give your tithe or give your offering. Amen. Be able to do that. So, and you can be have more and more blessings in your life. More and more blessings. So today we talked about receiving answered prayer. Oh, also visit us at myspiritfood.com. myspiritfood.org. You can see more videos there. You can also give there as well. So make sure you go there and visit us. And yeah, you could just get a lot of, it's a fun community that we have in My Spirit Food. It's a blessing. Our pastor is amazing. I'm the youth pastor there. So make sure you come and visit us there. And I just ask right now that everybody just has peace in their life. You know, there are a lot of questions that we might have in our life right now with what's going on, but know that we can receive comfort through the Lord Jesus Christ. We can feel that comfort that he gives us. So I want you to, you know, just walk in life with peace and knowing and expecting blessings. All right. So I want to pray for you right now. Heavenly Father, I just thank you so much right now for everyone that was listening to this sermon, that they are blessed from the top of their head to the bottom of their feet, and that they are going to have a blessed day, a blessed life, a blessed week. And if it's anything that's crooked in their life, that they're not on the right path and they need that spiritual Q-tip to clean out everything in their ears so they can hear from you clearly, do it right now, Heavenly Father. Do it in their life right now. Help them to hear. Help them to see. And I just thank you for all the peace that you are giving them, the peace that you're giving me, the comfort. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Now, y'all know I like to end it with some music, So I'm going to play some music real quick. You know I like to do that. Let me play that music real quick for y'all. Let me see what I can play. Yeah. Oh, yeah. And for the tithe, I'm going to say that one more time because I know if it goes through real quickly. I want you to text MYSFCC to 77977. I actually missed the seven. So it's MYSFCC to 77977. And if you want to send via P.O. Box, you can send it to P.O. Box 794, Woodland Hills, California, 91364. P.O. Box 794, Woodland Hills, California, 91364. And you can send it that way. Yeah. All right. Let's get it. Let's get it. Let me see. Let me play something for y'all. Amen. Amen. Oh, yeah. You know what? I want to play this because this is about kindness. So I want to play this song. This is awesome. Play something about kindness. Let's play this real quick. Kind, y'all, be kind. The kindness of a place I've never known. That's what we've been talking about. God's kindness will take you to places you've never been. Close to the Lord. Come on. Stay close to Jesus, y'all. Come on. All I ever wanted. Hallelujah, come on. Pray in the spirit to this song. Worship in the spirit. Come on. Hallelujah. Your kindness changes me. You're not alone, okay? Come on. Hallelujah. But you call me your own. You call me your own. Woo! Gave me a new name. Gave me a new name. Hey! What's up, sis? I see you, Kyrie. What you know about Isla Vista worship? Hey, amen. Kindness. Woo. All I ever wanted is to be close to you. Be close to you. Come on. Be close to Jesus. Let these words speak to you, okay? Always love you. Close to you. Get close to Jesus, y'all. Get close to that kindness. Let him change your mind. Take a deep breath out. Feel that kindness. It's gonna be okay, y'all. Hallelujah. 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 I love y'all. God bless y'all. Have a blessed day. Be kind to someone. Stay close to Jesus. Love y'all. Hey!